We prepare to listen to a sermon reflection on the reading of Scripture today. I would like to pause for a moment to recognize and celebrate that today is the day we call Father's Day. It's a time where we can remember the gifts that God had planned into the lives of all people, that fathers would be there and support and encourage and love. And when that happens, it's a beautiful gift. But we're aware that it doesn't always happen. And many people struggle with this concept. But here today, we just give a thankful note of gratitude for God's gift of those fathers in our lives that have led us and blessed us. Let us now turn to the hearing of this thoughts around the gospel reading in Mark, the calming of the storms. Last week, I spoke about living in a divided world and how culture, business, religion, and politics and personal relationships are all caught up in creating barriers, but how Jesus, the author of life, calls us to a different way. Now, with today's gospel reading, we are in the place where we can see what Jesus' disciples of all ages and generations are made of. Always remembering that when we apply the biblical teaching to our lives today, we can be transformed. This is the work of God's Spirit alive in our time, in circumstances and situations relevant to us today. So I will start with this question for you to contemplate while you listen, but perhaps even throughout the week. What are you made of and known by? A current TV commercial tells us we are all known by algorithms. As you might know, algorithms are digital code that knows what we want, when we want it, and how willingly we sacrifice to get it. I don't know about you, but that bothers me, and I do try to adjust my smartphone and computer settings to minimize the effect on my life. But the bright side of the commercial message is that on the newest phone, you can turn off the algorithm apps and make your own decisions for yourself. Yay! Good for the telephone company. Well, you and I, those claiming to be disciples of Jesus, today need to have our ears and eyes open to see and hear the work of the Holy Spirit in us today. Not the work of algorithms, but the work of God. In the Gospel of Mark, Jesus has been explaining his teachings to those who would listen and choose to follow him. But early in Mark's Gospel, we do not fully know what they think about him, about Jesus, even for those that are closest to him. So Jesus, I like to think, takes them on a field trip, just a few students to experience the practical application of their learning. A night boat trip across the lake is in itself an additional lesson, as the Jews and the Gentiles are divided by that lake, and this new context will be quite eye-opening for them. But the boat trip itself is an opportunity for Jesus' followers to reveal what they know or do not know about Jesus and what he has been teaching them. They get caught in a night storm, and even the professional fishers among them become fearful of the storm, and they wake Jesus up out of his deep sleep at the back of the boat. We know Jesus' response. He speaks and calms the storm with absolute authority, and then looks to his disciples, his students, and asks, "Why are you frightened? Do you not trust me even yet?" In amazement, they ask each other, "Whoever can this be? Even the wind and the waves do what he tells them." When has this happened to you? Professed followers of Jesus Christ in 2021, have you ever been awestruck by Jesus' power and authority? In the presence of these disciples, Jesus had healed the sick, cast out demons, raised the dead, forgiven sin, exposed absurd accusations by those who feared him, and revealed the truth. But often that voice in our head says, "Oh, but that's different. That doesn't happen now. That's just story." I would ask then, what do you believe? What did those disciples believe? In the midst of turmoil over and over, Jesus speaks, and at once there is great calm in the individuals healed, in the families restored, in the soul set free. There is no magical procedure that Jesus follows to defang the ferocity of the so-called natural world, just as there is none when he overwhelms unclean spirits, potentially life-threatening illness, the damage to bodies, and even death. In all these situations, Jesus simply, authoritatively speaks and/or makes contact, and things that bring destruction compound suffering lose their capacity to inflict additional harm. The internal storms within us, the external storms around us, the physical storms of nature, all are calmed by the spoken word and living presence of Jesus. The disciples then, and we now, are witness to the core eternal authority that is Jesus Christ. If we do not believe that, our faith is vain, empty, formless, and having no substance. But if we do believe that core eternal authority that is Jesus Christ, then we have been called to even greater things. So right now, in our world and time, and the consequences we have been commissioned to speak into, we are able to speak calm into the storms of our world, to speak unity in the face of division, to live grace instead of retribution, to speak hope, not despair. We have been commissioned to be peacemakers, to offer grace, to speak and teach the power of God into our circumstances. Jesus did not abandon his disciples, even though they doubted him or questioned him. He did not abandon those disciples when they were awestruck, confused, fearful even, at seeing Jesus in his full form. And Jesus will not abandon you when you, or we, human as we are, feel inadequate, insufficient, unsure, ineffective. We need to read the scriptures, the scripture narrative, and learn from it. It is not just story. It is eternal, living word. That's why it applied to the time that we read of in the scriptures, the time of Jesus on this earth. That's why we read it today. It is eternal, living word, active, engaged today. seek out the confidence of the Spirit of God working in and through you. Allow Jesus, the light of the world, to shine through your words and actions. Perhaps listening to the prayer of a child might inspire and encourage you. So Tiana, my 19-year-old daughter with Down syndrome, who aspires to be a devotional writer, I think she's well on her way, wrote these words as I read to you, with her permission, from her prayer journal in May 2021. Dear God, now we all can hear your small voice through the silence, and we all can feel your present love with all of us. You whispered in our hearts to move forward a next step that we all need to have in the future when we will wait for you to come into our lives in this quiet moment. As we will set aside time to praise you only and to read your living word, so let your blessings flow through rain to shine and into all poems which will inspire your son to turn off the sound. Practice giving thanks to only you and to study your character, to soak in your promises. Please let us have just one step at a time together. Walking with you on this holy path is leading in a right direction to follow you only. In Jesus' name, the unstoppable. Amen.